1,000 people. 1,000 people. When I first got started on Instagram, it took me over half a year to get 1,000 people to follow me while I was doing something that I loved. And then I come to YouTube and I've been here for 3 weeks, 3 videos. That's all I had on my channel. And over 1,000 people decide to show up and cheer me on. Just imagine that you decide that you're going to get healthy 1 year, right? You set your New Year's resolution, you're finally gonna get fit, so you decide that you're going to the gym every single week. So you go and you're doing okay, but you're running off your own steam. And then the fourth time that you show up, you turn around and there are 1,000 people cheering your name, like, Jeremy, Jeremy. That's what this is. That's what this feels like. If you ever hit this point and it doesn't feel like that, you're doing something wrong. To the over 1,000 people who showed up to back my play after I've been here for less than a month, you're amazing. I can't tell you what it feels like from my end, so all I can do is show my gratitude. So, we're gonna do something a little ahead of schedule. I'd originally planned to do this one a couple months down the road for my 1,000 video, but all of you showed up to this house party early, so I guess we're breaking out the carne asada and we're gonna do this now. Looks good. Cool, so, this is the Like Lightning deck. It's a beautiful deck of cards. There's only 600 of this particular edition floating around the world, and I was saving it for a special occasion. Today feels good. And this is Yo. It's a flourish that I get a lot of credit for because I will not stop doing this. I do it on every single deck of cards that I've ever opened. In fact, tell me if this looks familiar with the smirk. Incidentally, that photo was taken by Lloyd Barnes a few years ago, and when he showed it to me, I told him I will never look cooler than I do in that picture. And so far, I've been right, which is why that photo is my profile picture on every social media platform. Now, the flourish itself belongs to a guy named Lee Asher. In his notes, sex sells. Lee is one of those guys that if you don't know who he is, you're kind of missing out because he is a verifiable badass that can make these babies sing and dance. But a lot of his early work was only ever published in physical form, so you'd have to go hunting for a while to realize that it's his. And then it was made popular again by the Verts, right? The guys who did the Virtuoso deck. And when they do it better and higher than everyone else in the world. When they throw those cards, they go 4 feet up into the air, and I swear to God, you could brew a cup of coffee before they come all the way back down. But I figured since I've been doing it for a while, I'd show you what I know about it, and then you can decide how high you want to make it go. Let's talk about the grip. Hold the pack by the short ends, top and bottom. Your pinky is going to go along the base, these fingers are going to rest along the side, and the first finger is going to come over the top. This is called a straddle grip. And then all you're going to do is turn your hand over, let them fall into your palm, and then extend all of your fingers straight up. And it's just caged in there. It's not going anywhere, but it's loose. Now, the secret to Yo is to let the cards bevel against your first finger a little bit, and then on the way down, they fall against your pinky. That's it. Now, what do I mean by pre-bevel the deck? Means that I want the cards to start off in that shape. I want them leaning forward. And to do that, I just place them in my hand. I let the pinky touch a few of the bottom cards and the rest of the cards just sort of lean in toward my first finger. And that shape allows air to sneak between the cards. And that's really important. One of the reasons that Yo works is because of an equal friction among all of the cards. They all slide at about the same rate. And the more air you have between the cards, the easier they slide among each other. Think like air hockey. And that's also why this move is a lot harder to do with older decks or with new decks where a couple of the cards are worn down. It's because there isn't equal friction among all of the cards, or there's too much friction and they don't slide well enough. The other reason why Yo works is because of centripetal force. That's the force you have to apply to something to not stop it, but just change its direction. Think of like the way a softball pitcher pitches a ball. You're doing the same thing here. When the cards are in motion, everything in them wants to just slide forward. And then you're applying a bit of centripetal force to change the direction to point it straight up. But that's adding energy to the cards, which causes them to slide even more. And then when they run out of energy, they all come sliding back down to my pinky. My other fingers just grip onto it to straighten everything out. And that is how you get Yo. Now, once you play with this enough, you'll start to realize that the top cards follow the lead of the bottom cards. Wherever these guys are determines where these guys are. So, what you can do is you can rotate your hand mid-throw, and it causes the cards to have to rotate in the same direction as the bottom cards. But one of the coolest things about Yo is that it can float the line between cardistry and magic if you want it to. It can either be this beautiful flourish that makes you feel like a badass, or it could be the end to a beautiful trick, a great way to display a chosen card instead of just turning it over. So let's say there's some card that you want to display at the very end of a trick. You've got it on top, it's ready to go. And instead of just turning it over, all you have to do is one, spend years mastering Yo. But then once you've got that, create a discrepancy between it and the rest of the deck. All you need is a difference in friction. That's it. Right? You just upjog it. And now there's less card to travel. And then to add a bit of air, when everything bevels against your first finger, that card is stuck against your first digit, which only adds air, and there's less card to travel. So when you go to do Yo, it travels faster and higher than the rest of the deck. And now you can catch it. Now, as far as I know, the only other person that was thinking about Yo in magical terms outside of Lee when it first came out was R. Paul Wilson. That's right, heavy hitter close-up guy, it turns out, was thinking deeply about how to turn a flourish into magical moments. It was his idea that you could isolate specific meaningful cards using Yo and make it into a magical effect. I got permission to teach one of his versions in my download, and then I spent the next year exploring all of the crazy stuff that you could do with this, and it turns out there's a lot. You could take the top card, do Yo, and stab it into Yo, mid-spread, mid-air, and have that stab be meaningful. You could throw it up, kick your wrist, and have it split at some point that you mean to, and have the other half land in the other hand. All of these things are possible if you just learn to dance with the friction. So, that's Yo. I hope you guys like that, I hope you use it, and I hope you come up with things that I never would have thought of. And when the world opens back up and you catch me at a magic convention, I hope you're willing to sit down and teach me. To everyone who subscribed, again, thank you. You guys are amazing. To everyone who has liked and commented, thank you guys for the encouragement and thank you for the honesty. I appreciate it. Until next time, I'll see you guys soon.
Don't do balloons while you have air conditioning running. It's harder than it looks.